Right, Aki Karime for BBTV. I'm delighted to be over at Ricky Hatton's gym here in Hyde. And Ricky, it's like the disappearing man. you've shed a lot of weight here. How much have you shed so far?
Shed about a stone and a half, I think. But just like when I was fighting, to be honest with you, you know, I always left myself, in between fights, left myself a mountain to climb. But this year I've left 10 years to climb. So I've got a little bit more to shift. But no, I've just done like, you know, just like you did when I was in training camps, you know, used the first few weeks just to, you know, loads of cardiac work, loads of road work. I've been doing like 3 workouts a day, just getting a sweat on, regular workouts. Really extreme with me diet just for them first few weeks. So when I start doing things like today, you know, like my bar bag, the pads, the prowler, my weights and all that, the physical side of things, I can eat properly then because I've already broke the camel's back, as they say, you know. So what I did years ago, I'm still doing today with a few little tweaks and changes here, working with Blaine from day to day. I mean, even things like weight training. I mean, Kerry Kays, as you know, was the best ever. But even weights have still come on a little bit, you know what I mean? You know, with the stretches and the exercise in between the lifts and stuff like that, you know, which has been great. You know, still learning at 43.
Yeah, well, people can't call you Ricky Fatton anymore now.
Well, I'm sure he'll soon be back. But no, I want to try and I've said it for as long as I can remember. After every fight, I've got my weight down. People say you look so much better, and it's never lasted. But I think I'm getting a little bit older and longer in the tooth now. I think hopefully this time, you know, I get the weight off, I'll stick to it because I'm in the gym training every day. I do my workouts. I do, you know, you see me social. I do my bag work. I do my runs, and I think if I can keep on top of it, because what I was doing when I was 23. In fact, I'm happy to say I'm not doing when I'm 43 now. So, you know, yep. Life changes, and hopefully this is Ricky for good now.
Yeah, well, this shedding of weights obviously pertains to this comeback fight on the 2nd of July at the AO Arena, formerly the Manchester Arena, against a Mexican legend in Marco Antonio Guerrero. Now, this a great dance partner, and I'm sure it's like both of you are looking forward to actually getting in there and just seeing what each other are about and just rolling back the years in that sense.
No, it's brilliant. I mean, it was put to me. I was asked a couple of years ago when the first exhibition came out, Mike Tyson and Roy Jones, they said, oh, would you be interested in a bit of that, Rick? And I obviously said, yeah. I said, because when I made my comeback against Senchenko several years back, I knew that my best days were behind me, and I still stand by that. Mm. But, you know, to do an exhibition with bigger gloves, less rounds, shorter rounds, and, you know, with the right organization putting the thing together with the right opponent against the ring, I said, ah, absolutely, why not? When they said Marco Antonio Barrera, it's a very easy decision for me to make. And they said, what we want to bill it as, Rick, is COVID has been a very difficult time for all of us. You know, I think there's people out there that are listening that we've lost family through COVID, friends through COVID. I've lost family through mental health through COVID. You know, so when they said, we're coming out and we're all back to normal, if you like, what about Ricky doing one last move around at the Manchester Arena against Marco Antonio Barrera? And we can use it as a positive stint, you know, coming out of lockdown, you know, I mean, mental health and, you know, for my own well-being, to go in a training camp, get fit again, you know, set my training regime out, sort me running out, get my diet right. And I like to think it inspires the kids I'm training, you know, I'm training these days. You know, you say, God blimey, look at him at 43 still. Because if you remember, 6 or 7 years ago, I was a mess. You know, yeah. I nearly wasn't here, you know, when it's the well documented, the problems I had. And I think come July the 2nd, if people are out there with mental health, I'll go, could you remember Rick? Do you remember Rick 8 years ago, 10 years ago, the state of him? Look at him now, look, I can. If you can do it, I can do it. And so it was a very easy mistake. When people say, why are you doing it? I think it's pretty straightforward why I'm doing it, you know, to try and do something positive, not only for myself, for my own well-being, for other people's well-being, and to hear the crowd again. You know what I mean? I'm retired, I'm not dead. Yeah. You know what I mean? Yeah, you know, still got to set myself goals and dreams to set, and I'm still living my dream.
The crowd was always something that was spectacular to behold. I mean, I remember getting up in the middle of the night to watch you fight in the bigger American fights. But before that, the following you built was absolutely huge. I mean, the era and the generation that tune in and watch your fights, I mean, they're probably really excited about this. Even though, as you said, it's a move around. But you're going to put on a show as well, aren't you, I hear?
Oh, without a doubt. You know, listen, let's have it right. It is an exhibition, and it is, you know, less rounds and shorter rounds, and it's with Marco. And me and Marco, you know, we're friends. We've been friends for years, and But, you know, he's not going to want to come to Manchester and have me box the ears off him. Yeah. And I'm not going to want him to come to my manor, to Manchester and box my lugs off, you know. So that's where the competitive side comes in. But me and Marco are not daft. We know what's enough and what's not enough, what's too much, you know what I mean? And listen, I wouldn't bother doing it. If I thought that any of my fans would go away from this night and go, what a waste of time that was. I was nearly falling asleep or anything like that. That would be like a dagger through my heart anyway, you know what I mean? My fans have always, you know, come to be entertained when I fought, and they'll be entertained July 2nd, 100%.
And we've seen that you working with Dan Hardy today, who's a brilliant, who's a brilliant MMA fighter, and the undercard, I believe, is going to have some quite interesting fights on it and matches on it. Yeah. Can you tell us a little bit about the undercard?
Yeah, there's going to be people there from different fields, you know, like Dan's come around and had a move about with us today. We're going to have, you know, UFC legends fighting. We're going to have... we're going to have rappers and we're going to have live music acts, you know, and they won't be in it as not a box. It's not a boxing show. It's like a celebration, a bit of fun, you know, after coming out of COVID. So we've got live music. We've got, you know, me and Marco, got UFC fighters. We've got rappers on. We've got live music acts. That's exactly what it's going to be, a celebration of coming out lockdown, you know, and for me to, if somebody had said to me a few years ago, you know, when I was in my real bad ways, that, listen, don't worry about it, Rick. In 10 years' time, you'll be having a move around at the Manchester Arena with Marco and Tony Oberera. Oh, no. And people say, why are you doing it, Rick? Come on. That's why I'm doing it. I'm having a move around with Marco and Tony Oberera. I'm an ambassador for mental health. I've lost family due to the lockdown. Why am I doing it? You know, if you don't know why I'm doing it, you need to get back to school because you're the fucking nugget.
Yeah, fair enough. And at the end of the day, this is going to inspire other people, I believe, as well. Especially with the following you've got, and so even if you just help one or two people,
that's the thing, isn't it? And it makes me proud. Like, a couple of young amateur boxers come to me the other day. And they went, oh, I've seen you on your Instagram, Ricky. I've seen you doing your training. He went, I need to train a bit harder. And I went, what do you mean you need to train a bit harder? He went, because if you're doing that at 43, I need to pull my socks off.
Yeah.
which made me chuckle. But, I mean, that's inspiring the youngsters. They're saying, look at 43, look at this, what he's doing. And if it helps someone out there with mental health, if a youngster comes and says, look at the dedication, look how he still puts it in at 43. There's nothing negative to come from this event, Aki. Nothing negative whatsoever. It's going to help me. It's going to help other people. And listen, you know, we're going to have a party. We're going to have a big celebration of coming out of lockdown. I've lost family through lockdown. It's been horrible for my family, some of the things that we've been through. And if I know there's more, I know there's people out there that have been in the same boat as me. And, you know, what a wave, you know, one last time. And my friends who went to watch me when I was fighting, they're saying, oh, they've been telling their kids for years, oh, you should have gone to see Ricky. Well, they can tell their kids now.
Now they can.
So, you know, is there anything, you know, you put all that thing together, mate. Is there anything bad to come out of this? No. And, you know, I know people out there saying, oh, we don't want to see you get hurt. Trust me, you know, have a bit of faith in the hitman. Nobody's going to get hurt. It'll be competitive. Of course it will. It's going to be competitive. I wouldn't bother doing it. But, you know, you don't have to worry about me. I won't get hurt. You're going to, you know, after all the people that are saying, oh, what are you doing it for and this and that, trust me, come July 2nd, you'll all be coming home going, wow, that was worth it.
And you showed today as well that you've still got the angles, the movement. You never really lose that, do you? And it looks like you've still got that muscle memory. And, you know, you could show some glimpses of some of the old stuff.
I've not even started yet, to be honest with you. I've still got 8 weeks to go. 8 weeks on Saturday coming up. Still got 8 weeks to go. But yeah, the difference when I started my weights and started my bar bag and everything like that, the difference in a week and days, you know, where it's like, first time I did it, I thought my heart was going to jump out, my body was like, oh, jeez. But after a couple of weeks under my belt, it's flying, and I've still got 8 weeks to go. I'm not even close to where I want to be come fight night. But it makes me excited, because the first time I started the bar, I thought, oh, no, was this a bad idea? You know what I mean? No, is it going to come back? And it, you know, muscle memory, you come back. My God, in the space of a week.
Yeah.
And that's what's got me excited a little bit. But he's still there, the little fat lad, you know what I mean?
And that's July the 2nd. People can get, where people want tickets, do they contact the arena directly?
Yeah, hattonbarera.com, you can get tickets on. Yeah, and I think, you know, there's probably people out there that are still, you know, oh, I'm not sure about this, you know, don't want to see him get hurt, what's he doing it for? Oh, no, no. if you buy a ticket, you will not be come home disappointed. There's nothing bad to come out of this, I swear to God. Ricky Hatton never lies.
There you go. And just on a final note, Ricky, I just want to get, because obviously you're an expert in breaking down fights as well. People have been asking for your opinion on the big fight this weekend, Canelo Bivol. Now, some people are saying that Canelo maybe has bitten off more than he can chew with this fight, going up to light heavyweight to fight someone so good. But what is your take on it?
I think this could be one of his toughest fights. You know what I mean? He's going up to light heavyweight. But, I mean, he's handled it when he fought Kovalev. Do you know what I mean? He moved up to, you know, he moved up the weight, fought the bigger man, and he looked strong and powerful. But I think he was losing by a midges, you know, in that fight. I think the fight was in the balance and that. But having said that, I think Canelo was fighting the fight like he knew he could turn it on. When the minute he wanted to put his foot down on the gas, he could turn it on. But this kid is very, very tasty. He's a little bit bigger and he's a little bit fresher than Kovalev was. So I think this could be potentially Canelo's hardest fight. I've always said I don't see anybody beating Canelo. I think Mayweather created a monster, do you know what I mean? When he boxed Canelo's, you know, ears off all them years ago, he absolutely created a monster. And I think he'll go up through the weights and win titles. I think he'll carry that strength with him. And he'll carry that strength with him because he's so slick defensively that he takes the size difference away from the opponent because of his movement and stuff like that. And I think that will be the big key with someone who's a little bit fresher than Kovalev was. Very, very tasty, very talented fighter. But I think Canelo will find a way to win like he always does.
You think it's going to go the distance?
I think it probably could go the distance. Probably Canelo on points.
Ricky, thanks very much for your prediction and thanks for your time.
Cheers,
today.
Mate. Good to see you
and
again.
Looking forward to July 2nd, and we'll track this on in the build-up. Thanks a lot.
Sound, mate.